morning, good morning, good morning. Good morning, everyone. Come on in. I know it's a holiday today, but come on in. Maybe you're listening to the replay. Welcome. Good morning, Missy. You up early? Good morning. You got to work today? Good morning. Good morning. Come on in, everyone. Come on in. Good morning, Erica. Good morning. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Come on in, everyone. God is changing your story. Good morning, Evangelist Charlotte. God is changing your story. He's rewriting your story even right now. God is rewriting some things. Yes. Yes, yes. Yes, from defeated to winning, from lack to abundance. Yes, yes. How we think the story is going to end, it's not going to end that way. He is changing our story even as we speak. Even as we get on the call this morning, he is rewriting some things. Yes, yes. Come on in, come on in. We'll give it about another minute and then we're going to go ahead and get started. Good morning, Miss Iris. Good morning. Good morning, Patricia. Good morning. Yes. Good morning, sis. Good morning. Good morning, First Lady Nina. Good morning. Yes. 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 God is rewriting. He's changing your story. Yes. What we think is going to happen. It's not going to happen the way we think it's going to happen because he's already changed it for us. See, we look in the natural eyes, but God, he's not a natural God. He's not a natural God. Good morning, Tori. Good morning, good morning, good morning. All right, we're going to go ahead and we're going to get started this morning. Turn this down. We're going to go ahead and we're going to get started this morning. Good morning, everyone. I know it's a holiday, but we still rock on regardless if it's a holiday or not. God still is sitting on the throne. He is still worthy to be praised. And I praise and thank God for each and every one of you for getting on this morning. For those of you that are sleeping in, I am mad at you. You can catch the replay. I hope you are catching the replay. We're going to go ahead and we're going to bow our heads. Dear most gracious Father God, we just love you, God. We praise you. We thank you, Lord God. Lord, as you give out your word this morning, oh God, I ask right now that you go into the homes of each and every woman that's listening right now, Lord God. Lord God, open up their hearts, open up their minds, oh God, to receive what you have given me today, Lord God. Lord, I ask that you decrease me and increase you, oh God. Lord, let your Holy Spirit just flow right now in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God. We thank you. We thank you right now, God, for changing our story, oh God. We thank you right now for rewriting our story, oh God, for making it different than what we think it's going to be, oh God. We thank you, Lord. We thank you in Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, amen. And I'm not going to be before you long. I'm serious, y'all. When this is over, I'm probably going to go get back in the bed. That's my holiday. It's a holiday. I don't have to go to work today. But anyhow, so this today, what is today? What is today? And We know that today is a holiday. Today is Labor Day. Today is Labor Day. And Labor Day is a holiday that we have. Good morning, Robin. Labor Day is a holiday that we have been celebrating for years, over 100 years. And just a little bit about Labor Day. Labor Day actually became a holiday in 1894. And it basically constitutes a yearly national tribute to the contribution that workers have made to the strength, prosperity, and well-being of our country. So basically, it's a day that we celebrate the laborers, those that work, those that built the country, those that, you know, had, came up with machines or ways of doing things, ways of strengthening our United States, ways of just, you know, coming together and making it a better place here in the United States. And so that's why we take the time to celebrate Labor Day, and we take the time off for those that who labored among us. And so today, you guys know that the ninth month, I always go into the birthing season, because I do feel as though the ninth month of September is the birthing season, the 40th week. And I even talked about this last week. The 40th week is the last week of September. And that's how we know that that's how long a woman is pregnant, normally for 40 weeks. And so today we're going to be coming from John chapter 16, verse 21. And it says, a woman giving birth to a child has pain because her time has come. But when her baby is born, she forgets the anguish because of her joy of the child. Because of her joy of that child. And that's John 16 and 21. And I think back, I have three biological birth children. And I think about how every single time, you know, the very first time I was pregnant and I gave birth, you know, I was fearful. I was scared. I didn't know what to expect. You know, you're getting stories from everybody and their mama about what's going to happen, you know, how it's going to be. One person saying this, one person saying that, you know, and there was a fear that came upon me. You go through the pain of giving birth, you give birth, but as soon as you see that baby, it seems like you just forget everything. You know, you just look at that beautiful baby, that beautiful thing that just came out, that came out of you. You're like, that just came out of me. Right. And so, but while you're going through the pain, while you are pushing, you know, you're thinking to yourself, I ain't never gonna do this again. This is my last time. I'm not doing this no more. Right. And we think about that, but then, yeah, we go and we get pregnant again, and it happens over again and again. I mean, I even think about some of the women, that literally my mother-in-law, she had 12 children, 11 children. Her mom has 17 children, you know? So I think about the women who did this over and over and over again. And so I think about the process of labor, the process of labor. And even for Labor Day, because where we are now, we were not there in 1894. Right? We have evolved as a nation so much since then, right? And so I think about how the process of labor goes for us. I think about what God has put on the inside of us, how we have to birth out those giftings, those talents, those skills. We have to birth out the things that God has put on the inside of us. And the reason why we need to birth those things out is because God wants to take his people from one place to another, right? He wants to move his people, just like the laborers moved the United States and they moved us to a different place and it evolves. That's exactly what God wants to do with his people. And so we have to understand, as women of God, as vessels, that we can't be comfortable and expect change at the same time. We can't be comfortable and expect change at the same time. See, birth, it, when you're when you're having birth and when you're in labor, it causes a pain. It causes a pain with the gift and with the idea that God has put on the inside of you. In order for that thing to come out, it's gonna cause you some pain, and it's gonna go through different phases that you're gonna birth out. There's gonna be different phases. And so I think about, you know, when you're pregnant and you get ready to get close to having that baby, you have, some of you have what's called Braxton Hicks, right? You have those false contractions, those contractions, especially as a first time mother, or the first time you've been pregnant and you're getting ready to go into labor, and you know those false contractions come, and you think you're getting ready to go into labor, right? And so you're like, oh, they're coming. I can feel them. They hurt, you know. And some of you rush to the doctor, right? You go to the doctor, they hook you up, and they're like, nope, you're not ready yet. You know, go back home, right? 3-4 days later, you start having them again, right? You go back. And so that's what some of us do with the thing that we need to birth, with that we're birthing out, right? Sometimes it's a little bit premature. We think we're ready for it, and we think that that it's time, but it really isn't time, and we're really not ready for that thing to come out, right? And so then there's those of us that go into labor, and there's so many different types of labor. Labor is different for everybody. Some of us have long labors. You know, some of us are in labor for 10, 20. My daughter, she was in labor for almost 2 days in the hospital, you know, 24 hours and 48 hours just being in labor and anguish. And some of us are feeling that right now. You know, it's like, God, I know you want to birth this thing out of me. I know this thing is going to come out of me, but it's so long. I'm so tired of going through the pain. I'm so tired of going through the struggles. I'm so tired of going through the obstacle. Can you just get this thing out of me? But see, there's a reason why you're going through these long hours of labor, right? Because he wants to make sure that thing that you're birthing out is ready, that it's ready to come out. And when it comes out, it's coming out at an ease. And then you look at those women. I've seen women that just pop them babies right on out. They in labor for 1 hour or 2 hours. Some of them don't even have an epidural, and they're just able to pop those things out. And sometimes you feel like that. God, you gave them that idea, and they were able to run and execute that idea so quick. They were able to give birth to that idea so quick. But yet you got me over here, and I'm struggling. I'm still trying to get this thing together. I'm still trying to learn how to execute this idea. I'm still trying to see what you're giving me, the strategies you're giving me to birth this thing out. But yet somebody came out with the exact same thing, and they're moving, they're going fast. It's that quick labor. But don't compare yourself, right? We don't want to compare ourselves to other people, because God is working on us individually, right? And there's a certain people that we're called to, because that person, the people that they might be called to, might be ready. And so God needed that person to go ahead and have that quick labor while he's still preparing your people, my God, for you to labor among, my God. And so then there's some of us that we go into labor, and some of us don't need any kind of pain medications. Back in the day, even when my mom had me 40 years ago, there was no pain. There was no epidurals and all that different type of stuff. And so those women just had those babies. But I know when I had my babies, I got epidurals. There was something to help me get through the pain. And so God is saying this morning, I will send the Holy Spirit to comfort you. I will send my angels to be with you as you're going through the pain. I'm going to send you something so it'll ease the pain just a little bit, because you're going to birth this baby, but I understand that you need just a little bit of help. So I'm going to send you just a little bit of help so that you can get that thing out. My God, my God. And then there's the midwives and the doctors, right? Because some of us, we can't just birth that thing by ourselves. I've known women that have had babies in their homes or had babies different places by them. My niece, she had her baby in a car. There was no doctors. There was no nurses. But then there's some of us that need that midwife. We need that doctor to help us get that, to coach us along the way, to coach us to getting that baby out. That's coaching us on how we should breathe, how our posture should be. They're telling us, you know, when to push and when not to push. And so some of us need that extra help to get that thing out. And don't feel bad. There's nothing wrong with that. We all need the extra help at times in our lives. We all need the coaches and the mentors and the pastors and the spiritual parents to help us push that thing out and birth that thing, especially if we're in a long hour. So we need that wise counsel to help us get that thing out, because we've been laboring with that thing for far too long, and it's time to push that baby on out of us. And so I think about contractions, and I think about how intense the contractions are, you guys. And I think about, you know, the purpose. God, what's the purpose of the contractions? I know you said childbirth was going to be painful for us, but what's the purpose of these contractions? Why we got to have these contractions? And they start out, you know, 15, 20 minutes apart. And then as the baby is more crowned and ready to come out, the contractions get closer and closer and closer. And what he was saying was that the baby cannot move through the birth canal without the contractions. My God. See, that every time that contraction hits, that baby is being pushed a little bit further. Every time that contraction hit, that baby is coming out a little bit more. See, without the contraction, the baby can't come on down that birth canal. My God. So I said, Lord, so what are you saying? He's saying that every time you have that contraction, I'm getting you closer and closer to the place of birth. I'm getting you closer and closer to where you're going to go ahead. You're going to write that book and publish that book. I'm getting you closer and closer to where you're going to start that ministry. I'm getting you closer and closer where you're going to go back to school. I'm getting you closer and closer where you're going to go ask for the promotion on that job. Every time you have that contraction and every time that pain comes, he's getting you closer and closer to where you're going to birth that thing that he has put on the inside of you, that thing that he has cultivated, that thing that he has nurtured, that thing that he has put in and he's molding and he's getting ready to birth that thing out of you. With each contraction, you're getting closer to your promise. My God. Hallelujah. So we need the contractions. We need the contractions to help us push that baby right on down that birth canal. My God, my God, my God. And so, and I noticed one thing that, you know, when we have the contractions, right? And it hurts us so bad, but we know that baby is coming down. And then I noticed that every time I had the contraction, the doctor said, push. And I'm thinking to myself, why do I gotta push when I'm in pain? I don't wanna push while I'm in pain. Why do I gotta keep pushing while I'm in pain? I wanna push when I'm just laying there and I'm comfortable. But what did I tell you earlier? You can't be comfortable and expect change at the same time. See, when your body is relaxed and your body is comfortable, that baby can't come out. Your part down there where it got to open up and crown and dilate and do all those things, that can't happen when your body is relaxed and comfortable. See, when your body is in tension and that contraction comes and you're in that pain, that's when the doctor tells you to push. And so I'm telling you this morning, woman of God, is that it's the times that you're in pain is when you have to push. It's the times when you're in pain when you have to make sure that you're breathing correctly and that you're pushing and that you're pushing that thing out of you. It's not when you're relaxed, because when you're relaxed, you're not getting anything done. When you're relaxed, you're not going to the Father in prayer. When you're relaxed, you're not getting on your knees and crying out to God. It's when you're in pain, it's when you're crying out to God. It's when you're in pain, it's when you're laying and prostrate before God on your face, flat on your face, calling out to him, saying, God, I need you. God, I need you to step in. God, I need you to come in this situation. God, I need you to get me through this. God, I need you. I need you. I need you. It's only when you're in pain is when you do that. And through that pain is when he allows you to, when he's working on you to help you birth that thing out, is through that pain. My God, my God. And so we have to push during the uncomfortable times. Not when we're comfortable, but during the uncomfortable times is when we have to push. That's when we make the greatest strides, is when we're uncomfortable. Not when we're doing good, not when everything is going good, because see, we tend to fall back when everything is going good, when everything is lax. Have you ever noticed that when everything is going good in your life, you don't read your word as much? When everything is going good in your life, you don't pray as much. When everything is going good in your life, you don't have those conversations with God. You don't go to church as much. You don't listen to your inspirational word and your preachings and things like that when everything is going good. But when things start to get uncomfortable, that's when we run to Jesus. My God, my God, my God. And then there's even those seasons where with some of us, we have to get a C-section. My God, my God. And I've had two C-sections, my God. And y'all know a C-section happens when a lot of times when you've been in labor for so long, so long, so long, and that baby just don't want to come out, just don't want to come out. And so you have to go and you go into a C-section surgery where they actually have to, cut the baby and not cut the baby, but cut the baby out of you. Some of us go into C-sections. I remember with my second child, because the umbilical, I was in labor for so long, the umbilical cord got wrapped around his arm and his heart rate started to go down. So they wanted to do an emergency C-section. And some of you on this morning need emergency C-sections, my God. Some of you on this morning need to have somebody come and say, oh no, we finna take that baby right out of you. God is saying, I'm gonna have to take it out of you because you keep going on and on and on. You don't want to release that thing. The main reason why you don't want to release that thing is probably because of fear, because of false evidence appearing real. You're scared of what they're going to say. You're afraid of what people going to think of you. You're afraid of who's going to support you. But guess what? Let me tell you something. I don't want to hurt your feelings, but guess what? They don't really even care, y'all. They don't really even care. Have you even seen, I was reading the other day, have you seen celebrities, they've gone through so much on television. Y'all remember the whole Jada and Will thing and the entanglement and all of that stuff. Y'all remember that about a month ago? Who even really talking about that now? Ain't nobody really even talking about that right now. Let me tell you something. It's time to get over your fears. See, you think that everybody gonna talk about you. You think that if you fail, they gonna say, yeah, I see, she thought she was gonna do this. She thought she was gonna do that. Them folks ain't worried about you, baby. Get that thing up out of you. If you do fail, guess what? That's okay. It's not a failure. It's a learning lesson for you to go on to the next thing. Stop allowing fear to stop you. You're so scared that now God is going to have to put you into a C-section to get that thing up outside of you. No, we don't have the spirit of fear. We have to get over our fears, because what you have, somebody needs. Somebody is waiting on your yes. And don't make God give you that C-section so that you can't get that thing out of you, because somebody needs that thing. We got to get over our fears, you guys. We got to stop worrying about what everybody is going to say, what people going to think. Well, what if I don't make no money? It's all good, because it's a ministry. What people don't understand is what you have is ministry. The entrepreneurship, the business, what you're doing is a ministry. It's not about the dollar. See, we're a servant. We are servants first. And if you are a servant first, the money will follow. My God, I tell people all the time, Matthew 6:33, seek ye first the kingdom of God, and all these things will be added, and his righteousness, and all these things will be added unto you. Don't worry about the other stuff. You just worry about what God has given you to do. So if he told you to write the book, go write it. If he told you to start a podcast, go start the podcast. If he told you to go and start a ministry and start preaching online or in a house or wherever you are, go do that. If he told you to go back to school, go do that. If he told you to go ask for the promotion, go do that. Stop worrying about what people gonna think. Stop worrying about a no. Stop. Look, I'm in a multi-level marketing company, and the first thing that I learned is that I had to learn how to accept the word no, my God. Because when you're talking to people about getting signed up for whatever it is that you're doing, you're going to hear so many no's. And a lot of people, I have to work with them on that, because they feel rejected when they hear the no. But see, you can't feel rejected because they're not telling you no. I tell people all the time, they're telling the idea no. They're telling the idea of what you're doing, they're saying no. They're not telling you no personally. And so I'm here to tell you that guess what? Don't worry about what people say, because it's not you. Don't take it personal. It's not you personally, right? You got to still do what thus says the Lord. And so this is the ninth month. And I implore you guys, birth that thing out. If God said it's time, he's been putting, how do you know if he said it's time? Because he's put that thing down in your heart that's so strong. It's so strong. You can't sleep. You can't eat. You tossing and turning. You thinking about it every single day, almost every single moment. It's time for you to birth it out. If it's time, if he said go open a restaurant, go do it. Go open the bakery. Go do it. Go start the hair care line. Go start doing the wig. Whatever it is he's telling you to do, it's time to do it. It's time to do it. And he's going to be right there every step of the way. Amen. Amen and amen. And so I'm just so excited because I know that there's some stuff on the inside of each and every one of you. Iris, Patricia, Nina, Tori, every one of us, Shaky, Sharon, every one of us have something. God has given each and every one of us giftings. Don't go to the grave without sharing your gift to the world. Don't go to the grave having missed what you're supposed to do. There's so many people right now buried in the graveyard, and they're buried with their gift. The people that were called to them had to go somewhere else. Don't miss that opportunity. Don't miss the opportunity to share the goodness of God. Don't miss it. Don't miss it. And so Romans 10 and 9 says that if we confess with our mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in our heart that God raised him from the dead, we will be saved. And the reason why I like to say that, and we talk about that every time, is because some of us, we need to get back to that thing. We need to get back to Lord, what is it that you have for me? We need to get back before him. We need to call upon him. We need to repent of our sins and call upon him. Because some of the reasons why we can't birth that thing out is because we've been sinning and we need to repent. We need to repent and ask God for forgiveness. That's why we're having such a struggle birthing that thing out. Some of us have some habits that we need to get rid of. Some of us have some people we need to get rid of that's around us. So there's some things that we might need to get rid of in order for us to birth that thing out. But God is saying, come back to me. It's time. It's time, my daughter. It's time. It's time for you to go in labor. It's time for me to help you birth that thing out. I'm going to give you the necessary tools. I'm going to tell you how to breathe. I'm going to tell you how to position yourself. I'm going to tell you how to put them legs in the place where they're supposed to go. I'm going to tell you that. And not only am I going to tell you all of that, I'm going to put the resources around you. I'm going to put the nurses, the doctors. I'm going to put the anesthesiologists. I'm going to put everything around you that you need to birth that thing out. But I need you to come back to me. I need you to come back to your very first love when you very first fell in love with me, daughter. I need you to come back and just surrender. Put your hands up and surrender to me, daughter. That's what I need from you so that I can help you birth that thing out. Amen. Amen. And amen. Well, I appreciate you guys for getting on this morning. I know it's a holiday and some of you wanted to sleep in, but God is so faithful. He is so good. And I know that that is a word for somebody on here today, because it was definitely a word for me. And so we're going to go ahead. We're going to bow our heads in a word of prayer. Most gracious Father God, we just love you on today, God. We thank you, God. We ask that you forgive us of our sins, oh God. Lord, clean out our, search our hearts, oh God. Search our hearts and renew a right spirit in us, oh God. Whatever is not like you, oh God, we ask that you remove it right now in us, oh God. Lord, we want to birth that thing out of us, oh God. We want to birth out our dreams, our visions, oh God. We know that you have given us promises, oh God, and your promises are yay and amen, oh God. But God, we just need to come back to you, oh God. Lord, help us to come to you, fall to you, lean to you, lean not to our own understanding, but in all our ways acknowledge you, oh God, because we know that you're going to help us get this thing out of us, oh God. And when it comes out, oh God, we know that we're going to have pure joy, oh God. We're not going to remember the pain that we went through. We're not going to remember the struggles that we went through. We're not going to remember the obstacles that we went through, oh God, but we're going to have pure joy because we know that you did it. Nobody but you. We're going to give you the glory, we're going to give you the honor, and we're going to give you the praise, oh God. To God be the glory, because it's going to be nobody but you, oh God, that got us through it, Lord God. And so we thank you right now. We thank you for making our ways prosperous, oh God. We thank you for giving us something in our hands to work with, oh God. We thank you for the giftings, the skills, the talents that you have given us, oh God, to go and make our ways prosperous, oh God. We thank you for those things, oh God. We thank you for being the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We thank you for sitting on the throne. We thank you for sending your Holy Spirit, oh God. We thank you for sending your angels to encamp all around us, oh God. Lord, we just thank you. We praise your holy and righteous name. We give you all the honor and the glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, and amen. God bless each and every one of you. If you are off today, go and enjoy your day. And if you're not, enjoy your day anyway. I love you, and we'll see you back on here tomorrow morning, Reignited Prayer, 5:30 a.m. with Minister Tammy. God bless.